Another very important topic related to basic thermodynamics is the intensive and extensive properties. Okay, which properties are intensive, which properties are extensive? Okay, to knowing that is very important. And what is intensive and extensive properties? Intensive is independent. Okay, intensive over here, remember it like this, intensive ion, ion stands for independence, independent. Okay, independent of what? Independent of mass. All the intensive properties are independent of mass, and extensive properties are dependent on mass. Alright? So what are the properties? What are the examples of intensive and extensive properties? So try to remember what are the properties which are independent of mass. Okay, so independence of mass, first will be pressure. Okay, pressure will be mass of the body will not make any effect on the pressure. Okay, pressure is force per unit area. Alright, so pressure is intensive property. Then comes temperature. Okay, temperature also has no relationship with mass directly. Alright, so temperature is also intensive property. Then comes intensive property. Density. Okay, now this is tricky. Many times I have seen students making this mistake that they consider density to be extensive property, but density is an intensive property. Why? Because whenever I consider density, suppose this is a body. This is a body having density equal to rho. Now density of rho will be same over here if this is homogeneous material, and this. Suppose we are considering a small portion of the body, then the density will be same. The same of the same body, if we consider another portion of different mass, okay, then only the density will be same. Density is mass per volume, okay, mass per volume. But if we consider densities of all the portions of different masses, okay, the density will be same. So that will not depend upon mass if the density is uniform all over the body. Okay, so that is not directly affecting the density, so that's why density is an intensive property. But volume is an extensive property. Volume is an extensive property because if the mass increases, okay, if your mass increases, if you eat more and if your mass increases, then what will happen? Your volume will also increase. So volume is extensive property. Okay, don't do this mistake. Volume is extensive, density is intensive property. Alright? Then what are the other extensive properties? Extensive properties which depends upon mass. So we know about momentum, linear momentum. What is the equation of linear momentum? Mass into velocity. Okay? So linear momentum is extensive. That depends directly on mass. Similarly, kinetic energy, half of mv square. Okay, directly depending on mass. Kinetic energy. Or energy as a whole. Energy will depend upon mass. Okay? But in energy or entropy also will depend upon mass. So entropy is also an extensive property. But specific properties, all specific properties are independent, because when we talk about specific properties, specific means what? Suppose specific volume. What is specific volume? Volume per unit mass. So we consider specific properties for one mass only. Okay, so mass will be constant. So since mass is constant, so mass will not make any effect. Okay, so in case of specific properties, so all specific properties are intensive properties. So if volume is extensive property, but specific volume is intensive property. Energy as a whole is extensive, but specific energy is intensive. For example, specific entropy is intensive property. Okay, remember all intensive properties are all specific properties are intensive properties. Alright?